This video is about what happens to the dorsal horn or the posterior horn of the spinal cord when it is chronically bombarded by C fibers. C fibers are also known as chemosensitive nociceptors. These chemosensitive nociceptors are the most numerous sensory receptor in the body. It is also the most numerous sensory receptor of the spine. These are in comparison to the A fibers, and the A fibers are the large myelinated nociceptors, and these are responsible for quick transmission of pain. This is when you step on something sharp like a tack, and immediately you get a withdrawal response of your foot from the point of pain. Your brain localizes where the pain is in the postcentral gyrus, and the parietal lobe processes these A fiber stimulation as pain. Different for the C fibers. And what happens with the C fibers, particularly with chronic bombardment of the spinal cord, is we start to get some strange effects. One thing that happens with chronic bombardment by C fibers is we get more glutamate. Now, glutamate is a neurotransmitter. And it happens to be the neurotransmitter of choice for nociceptors. So the more glutamate that's available, the more nociceptive transmission that's available. Another thing that happens is that in order for glutamate to work, we need more receptors that will accept glutamate. As it turns out, we get more of those too. These are the N-methyl-D-aspartate receptors. And these receptors are designed to pick up glutamate. So more of these receptors present in the dorsal horn also lends to increased nociceptive processing at the level of the dorsal horn. Literature also says that we get more substance P production. Substance P has a lot of different functions, but one of the key functions that it has is that it decreases the threshold of nociceptors in the periphery. So what's happening now is the nociceptors that live in the periphery are more likely to fire. The way I remember this is if I was walking through a door, which can also be called a threshold, and it was low, I could get through it really easily. So these things are firing really easily. If I approached a threshold and it was high, like a high threshold, it would be harder to get into. And therefore, that's a high threshold, meaning less likely to fire. So we have increased glutamate, more NMDA receptors to uptake on the glutamate, substance P, which is diminishing the threshold of the peripheral nociceptors, making them more likely to fire. And we also get one more effect, which is pretty serious. And this effect is known as sprouting. Sprouting is an anatomical change in the dorsal horn, and where the different rexed lamina are organized, the layers of the dorsal horn are organized. What happens in sprouting in areas of lamina 1, they start sprouting into lamina 3 and 5 into 8 and 6 into 2. And this disorganizes the central processing of incoming sensory signals. Now, when I have disorganization of incoming sensory signals, my motor response to that is going to get confused. And this compromises optimal function at the level of the dorsal horn, in particular, level of function of our ability to adapt. The ability to adapt is homeostasis. And the dorsal horn has connecting roots directly into the higher centers of the central nervous system responsible for homeostasis. Homeostasis is built on a principle of incoming information tells you what's needed. The outgoing is a response. If the incoming information is no longer accurate, neither is the outgoing information. The other subject that comes up here when we start to talk about this effect is something called wind-up. And wind-up is ultimately the cumulative effect of all four of these items we just talked about, the glutamate, the receptors, the substance P, and the sprouting. Wind-up basically says you have a central nervous system that is built for processing nociception. It becomes kind of a nociceptive processing machine. And basically what happens in wind-up is that it's said that the dorsal horn interneurons now have a lower threshold for firing and processing nociception. So the dorsal horns have a lower threshold. I'll just abbreviate threshold here for you, for processing and receiving nociception. And what's really meant by this statement right here is the sum of the effects of increased glutamate production, increased NMDA receptors, increased substance P production, and sprouting.